difference between practicing and playing is huge. Some people think that they practice a lot because they play all day long or 3 or 4 hours, but that is not practice, that is playing. Playing meaning that you play a song or play stuff there that you can play. That is not upgrading your level. That gets you stuck in the same place. So practicing means that you practice things that you don't have control yet over those topics there, like rhythm. You need to do an inventory. For that, you cannot do alone. That's another thing. I've never seen one person that really can make good advancement alone without a teacher doing that. Therefore, we have this coaching program in Skype to show this difference and to analyze what you need to practice, because then it comes to the topic of practicing things that you like instead of what you need. That also is very detrimental for your progress. So if you want to advance in music, you need to get guidance first to not waste time, and then you will objectively observe how certain areas, maybe for some rhythm, for some it's scale playing, for some it's chords or they're weak in harmony, etc. The teacher should point out those things and then work on that in your practice time. I'm not saying don't play. We all play. But in fact, this is the difference between beginners, intermediate, and advanced players. People do a big deal to understand these things, and actually, it's very simple. This Paco said it also, this very clearly. Beginner is one who likes his existence with the guitar, his playing. He's first of all not practicing. He practices 10% and then plays 90% of the time. That's beginner. And of course he plays means he's inside the zone of comfort. His zone of comfort 90%. And only 10% is out, and maybe even less than that. That is beginner. An intermediate player can be 50-50, practicing 50% and playing 50%. Or maybe he can do inside zone of comfort 50%, another 50% outside zone of comfort. An advanced player means that they like, actually, not they only are exclusively inside, not inside the zone of comfort, but they live outside of the zone of comfort. This is an advanced player, because that's why they play like that, because you always go for the challenge of what you cannot do, and you actually learn to like to be outside of the zone of comfort, and then your life will become comfortable. This is the difference. So if you don't know what is the difference between practice and playing, and this by watching a video, you cannot learn it. Because even if you learn it in theory, there is no difference between practice and theory. But in practice there is. You know what I mean? So then therefore, why? Because there will be a gap there. And that's why you need a teacher. This alone, you cannot do it. You need to get proper guidance and coaching. So that's why we do this coaching thing in this kind. To teach people what's the difference between practicing and playing and what that means for you, how you will do it, not what to do. What to do you can understand, but how you will do it, this is the difficult part. And that's why the whole thing is about learning the difference between practicing and playing.
Pablo, Paco, ¿qué es para usted la música popular y qué es la música elitista?
Yo creo que la música elitista es el refinamiento de la música popular. Por ejemplo, el flamenco. El flamenco originalmente es una música popular, la música del pueblo de Andalucía. Pero creo que ya no le pertenece más al pueblo, porque de pronto habemos gente que nos hemos pasado toda una vida encerrados puliendo esa expresión popular. Entonces ha llegado a un nivel en el que el pueblo ya no tiene acceso, sobre todo a los matices que vamos consiguiendo la gente como yo, que pasamos muchas horas elaborando esa música.
Me ayudó porque descubrí ahí la improvisación. La improvisación es algo que yo pienso que cada músico del estilo que sea, del clásico, del flamenco, de cualquier otra música, debería aprender, porque la improvisación te da mucha libertad y a la vez te da mucho conocimiento de dónde estás tocando, de cómo estás tocando, de qué armonías están en cada momento, ¿no?